Hey everybody, thanks for watching. This is round two of the Long Beach Open at Skylinks, and I'm going to be following Monte. I'm getting out here just a little after his start. He's played two holes. I don't know anything about how he's done. So let's get into the action now. All right, guys, this is it. And obviously we just said that this is the second round. We pick up Monte on the third hole in the fairway after hitting a decent drive with his iron. He kind of hit it poorly, but it went right down the right-hand side. And now he has about 130 yards into this par four. And smothered that one a little bit and tugged it left. You can see, yep, just fell there. If you guys saw the first round that was at El Dorado Park golf course, then you guys are really going to enjoy this round. This is really going to be fun to watch, because some really wild things happen and also some kind of unbelievable things, but it'll be a lot of fun. So Monte hit a pretty poor lag putt there. For the first time in about 20 holes, Monte hit a poor lag putt. So he has that remaining for his par. This is Blake Schmidt. Blake is just made a beautiful putt there. And that actually is Blake's third birdie in a row. So he shot even par yesterday, and today he just started his round birdie, birdie, birdie. So Monte started his round bogey, birdie, and needs to make this to avoid another bogey. Monte misses that putt. Really was basically just a straight putt. But I think he read a little something into it that wasn't there. All right, so let's go on to the fourth hole. My camera is zooming in there. This is me shooting everything here. One man band here. So what my camera is shooting there is, this is the most dangerous driving hole of all the holes, because that kind of thick, I guess you would call it a thicket there, that protects the tee box of the third hole. You will not find your ball if it goes in there. So Blake Schmidt just hit it down the left-hand side. Hit it good. But so driver here is a pretty brave play, but Monte really doesn't lay up too often.
First decent swing in 2 days.
First decent swing in 2 days, Monte. So he totally killed that drive. It was really well. Look how well posted he is on this iron shot on that left leg. Really really a great swing to watch when it's sunk up. Okay, so Monte has this for birdie on the fourth hole. Here it's that. So as Monte rolls this putt, we're going to talk more about it later, but he uses a pretty unique putter called a directed force putter. There's a link for it in the description below, but it's pretty cool. It's got some cool kind of different technology to it. But that is a par for Monte. So he remains for the day one over par. Blake, who will follow his round a little bit, because he does a few pretty special things this day. All right, so Blake hit his onto the hole, onto the green, pretty close. Look how kind of smooth and soupy that looked for Monte. A really good iron shot there. When he gets his it basically effectively looks like his shoulders and hips are working together. All right, here's Monte stroking his birdie putt, but misread that one a little bit. And he had his other playing competitor, a guy named Dan, had gone before Monte and given him a line too. So Monte was a little bit more discouraged in that one than normal, because when you give these pros the line, they usually are pretty deadly. Nice putt, really good roll there. So that's Blake's card up there. So that's his fourth birdie in the first five holes. Pretty impressive. Go down to Monte's card here. Monte is now one over on the day, three over on the tournament, and the cut, we're thinking at this point, is going to be about three under. Blake Schmidt hitting off the tee. Hit a long drive. Blake is a very long player. Monty is a little longer than Blake. Well sunk drive there. Got everything moving through. Trying to keep it from going any further left. Let's take out a little replay of this. So watch the hips and the shoulders. Monty probably led with the hips a little more than he wanted to there. But squared around on it very nicely. This is a par 5, so Blake hit his about 330 down the left-hand side. Here at Skylinks, the fairways will run on a little bit. A little reminiscent of Jason Day there. You can see it just on the top of the screen there rolling. So Blake will have that for eagle. If he makes that putt, he'll be 6 under after 6 holes. So that's getting it done for sure. So Monty hit his 340 down the middle. And Monty had 185 yards. 185 yards to go here on this par 5. And you can see it just there. He went right over the flag stick. That was a 7 iron from 185. So Monty has this for an eagle. So this could change the complexion of his round pretty dramatically if he can get this one to go in. Ha! Dead center short, DCS. And just needed not even a full rotation more. Thought he made it for sure. The greens here at Skylinks normally can get pretty firm and fast, but a little slower than they were anticipating, especially for this tournament. Nice. So there's Blake, makes his eagle. So that's it. That's 6 under for the first 6 holes, and he's 6 under for the tournament. All right, so this is what they call the hardest hole in the course, the number one handicap. Over 430 yards. It's a dogleg left. It's actually from back here, about 455. Monty hit a very solid drive, very, very good. And as soon as he hit it, see how deep Monty's hips stay. As soon as he hit it, he said, miss that tree, miss that tree. There was that tree that he's underneath. It actually hit this little tree that is way down there. So now Monty is punching with what I believe is a very small 8 iron.
Be good as you look.
Yeah, wow. It just didn't grab quite like he thought it would. And it ran on just a little bit. But he has this birdie putt to get back to even for the day. Not really trying to make this, probably, if he was completely honest about it. But stroked it really nicely. Beautiful birdie. And is feeling a little better about his swing, he told me. And that was back-to-back birdie, so Monty moves to 1 under par. And his third birdie of the day. All right, so this, for most players, not usually a driver hole, but Monty's going with it here. It's only about 340 yards. Wasn't artistic, as Monty says.
Perfect. Wasn't artistic.
But it was perfect. Hit it way down there. Actually hit it so far that he hit it into a little bit of a tweener yardage here. You can see Monty has no angle. He was actually, and the ball's below his feet. 65 yards. And you could see that was a little bit of the wedge swing Monty would take in about 1994. That was a little bit stabby just because his angle was so poor. So hit it, ran it out to quite a bit, but his lag putting and touch. Monty has this certain way of dealing with touch shots, not only lag putts, but also pitches. If you've ever seen one of his clinics, it's really interesting. We'll get into it more on this channel, so stay tuned. But Monty makes a par and moves on to the 9th hole now. So Monty's 1 under after 8 holes. Moving on to the 9th hole, 224 yards. And Monty kind of stood the shaft up on this one. All of his long irons, he really felt like he was getting pretty steep with it, as he would say. The shaft angle was getting kind of steep on him. So Monty actually hit it over here where we're looking right now, and he chipped to that point I missed it on my camera because I was still walking up. And that is one under par for the first nine holes, 35 for Monty, and he is one over for the tournament. So going into the back nine, he knows he needs to at least shoot two under, maybe three under on the back to make it to the weekend. So let's move on here with driver on the 10th hole at Skylinks. That was hammered right down the middle. This is the hole that, if you guys saw the vlogs on my channel before, that's somewhat reminiscent of 10 at Riviera. That's the thing that the hole that I could compare it to the most. So Monty actually hit his with an absolutely perfect swing. It was just a little bit in the heel and a little bit low in the face, which is the only reason it didn't go all the way to the green. Hit a really nice chip there that just hit this green. If we zoom in, we might be able to see. Yeah, you can see there. Be right before the fringe is that thicker green tuft of grass that kicked his ball to the right. Otherwise, it would have been perfect. All right, so Blake gets, that is Blake's fifth birdie of the day after getting that up and down. He has five birdies and an eagle. So if he keeps making birdies, we're going to have to go on 59 watch pretty soon. I'm pretty sure the course record here is 61. So he'll have to shoot seven under on this back nine to shoot 59, which is seems pretty unreasonable, but these guys are good. All right, so Monty has this for his own birdie. After hitting such a good drive, you would want to make this. But yep, that's a head scratcher there because it broke away from the front of the hole, but there's a secondary hill here that he didn't think would influence it quite as much as it did. All right, 573, so we have about 569, par 5. Good speed through the ball. Monty usually has a club head speed, golf course swing club head speed of about 125. Hit a really solid drive, but it went a little bit left into that bunker. And then did not hit a great recovery shot out of that bunker. And that's the cart path we're looking at, and the hole about 160 yards away. The ball is lying pretty well, though, and the cart path is just about a foot and a half in front of his ball. Because that tree right there, that limb, was in his backswing, Monty had to be a little bit more conscious about his backswing, and it actually smoothed out his transition a little bit, and that one swing kind of, he later told me, got him back on track swing-wise. So Monty hit it nearly right over the pin, and it just went a little too far. So if you saw our pitching prescription video, you'll recognize this technique. Awesome chip. So from off the green, Monty holes out for birdie on this par 5 and goes 2 under on the day. So still an uphill climb to get to about that 3 under number that's going to be a requisite to get to the weekend. But it's now looking more doable. Like I said, if you guys would like to see more tournaments on this channel, if you would like to see more compelling and interesting content, why don't you go ahead and grab that pitching prescription video. There's a link for it in the description below. All right, so Blake birdied that last hole as well and is now 8 under for both the day and the tournament. He hit a good drive just a little bit right of these bunkers that are way out there. Monty with a driver here. Really putting a good move on the driver now. He's not let. Yesterday, the theme with driver was blocking it right. And today, he was just pounding it down the middle, which is pretty normal for Monty. All right, so Monty told me a lot of people say this is the hardest shot in golf. This is a 62-yard bunker shot. Monty, so what he told me was that was a pitching wedge explosion from there. And he said the way he plays it, it's not too hard of a shot. So Blake to go 9 under, misses that one and taps in for par, and he's 8 under. And this is Monty for back-to-back birdies and to go 3 under on the day and finally to get into red numbers for the tournament. Beautiful putt. Like I was saying before, the name of Monty's putter is called Directed Force. There's a link for it in the description below. Check it out because that company actually is sponsoring this video. And Monte absolutely loves the putter. It's what they call a lie angle balanced putter. So if you like to stroke it straight back and straight through, this will really be an amazing putter for you because it doesn't twist whatsoever. It's at directedforce.com. There's a link for it in the description below. On to the golf. All right, so Monte is on the par 3 13th hole, but he blocked it way right into the bunker. And Blake, who is 8 under on the day, just hit it onto the green and has that to go 9 under. So he's got that, I would say, about 18-footer to go 9 under. This is called Skylink, so there's an airport right next to this course, and that was one of the many planes that go over this course. And Monte hit a beautiful sand shot. So we complimented his sand shots before, but he really does hit them really well. Missed jarring it by half an inch, and here's Blake to go 9 under for the day and
nice
tournament.
Nice birdie, Blake.
Really awesome. Check out how smooth that stroke was. Pretty good.
Nice.
9 under is pretty good. So let's put him officially on course record watch and possibly 59 watch. All right, so Monte misread that on the low side. He was doing that quite a bit yesterday at El Dorado, and it came back at him today just a little bit. Had the read off just a little bit. So this is about a 349-yard par 4. Dogleg left, right over those trees where Blake is aiming is the tee box for the 15th hole. And Blake hit it just slightly right of what he wanted, but very solid. But when you take out driver here, you're really putting your score into the hands of luck, because there's some bunkers and a lot of little wispy trees that you can get stymied behind. Monte hit an absolute bomb, but it faded just a little bit. It would be right on the green if it hadn't faded a little bit, but he's in the greenside bunker about 335 yards out. Blake hit this straight up in the air and lands it softly onto the fringe, and now he has that to go 10 under, double digits under par for the day on the 14th hole if he makes that pretty simple putt, especially considering all the other ones that he's hit. Monte hits a very nice bunker shot, landed it just about a foot short of what he wanted to. And that's because of that foot, it jumped forward off the collar and ran out to this considerable distance here, especially because the level of bunker play Monte is. He would have liked to get it a little closer than this. This is breaking away from him. All right, he hit it right in the center of the putter. Nice, so that goes in, and Monte gets it back to 3 under on the day and 1 under on the tournament. That's a really great putt, little replay there. Here's for 10 under, no. Missed that one, but made his par, but 59 is probably gone away. Unless he can eagle the next hole, because this is a par 5, dogleg left. You
awesome
can see
drive.
That building there used to have a Boeing sign on it. And you would say, tell people, if you're a really long hitter, you want to hit at the left edge of that building. And that's what Monte did. Monte certainly is a very long hitter. So Monte here on this 15th hole is 179 yards out. He's got what he called a little 6-iron to me later here. We'll do a what's in the bag later, but Monte's clubs are really interesting. Hit it solid, just blocked it just a little bit. Transition there was maybe slightly quick. And blocked it a little bit, and now he has a really difficult, maybe even could have chipped it from there, but the chip would have been very difficult. Look at this putt, how wacky that is. Had to go way up there. So Monte has that to go 4 under on the day if he makes this putt. And really needs to make this one to have a chance to make this cut. What an awesome roll. He matched the speed and the read together. Some friends of ours off the green saw that one. 141 yards, you guys saw this hole in my vlog recently. We do a lot of different vlogs on this channel, and it's been getting really fun. So 141 yards to the center of the hole, It's actually a little short of that today, a little bit in the front. So Monte hit his just onto the front of the green, and that's actually a really good spot because he has an uphill putt. So this will be to go 5 under on the day and get himself 3 under for the tournament, and left it again, DCS, dead center short. And that really hurts, especially. It's just hard to get yourself to hit it hard enough on these greens because they're a little slower than you're used to. So let's move on. Monte stays 3 under for the day, and now we're on the 17th hole. He hit it really solid. I mean, he has been hitting his driver so much better this day than the day before, a lot more the norm for him. But you can see, I mean, later he said that this was really unlucky because if it had jumped forward, it would have been a little better. If it was back in the bunker, it would have been a little better. But he caught that way cleaner than he thought he would have. It went directly over that flag stick that you can see there and ended up short-sided. The flag stick was well in the back of the green and ended up short-sided here on the 17th hole. Monte is now pitching for birdie. If he makes this, though, he'll be 5 under on the day. Just got a little unlucky with the type of grass and the direction it was growing just in before the green there. It grabbed it and it did not release it. So Monte has this long putt to stay 4 under on the day and 2 under on the tournament, knowing that at least 3 under is going to be needed to make the putt. It was a great stroke and it was positive, but the line was not right. And Monte actually goes very, very quickly on these 4-footers. And actually he went all 2 days without missing a single one of them. There were some edges here and there, but they all went in. And he just says he has a lot of confidence on these 4-footers. So Monte, with that bogey, is now 3 under. For his round. And here's Blake for birdie. He actually bogeyed that par 5 that Monte birdied recently. So that takes Blake to 9 under on the day. He has made an absolute killing with the birdies. Unbelievable. So Monte hit an absolutely crushed drive.
That is so long. My God.
All right, guys, so a little update here. We're on the final hole of the day, and Monte has just hit an enormous drive, really, really long drive down the right-hand side of the fairway. He is sitting, I don't know, gosh, about 7, maybe 65 yards from the hole on this, it's over 400 yards. Overall, Monte is 1 under for the tournament, 3 under on the day, I think, and but really, 3 under is going to be the cut. No chance at 2 under. 3 under is even iffy. So, really doing well to make some birdies today and pull some kind of a swing out. Maybe pressing a little bit last couple holes, or really just the last hole, trying to make something happen from a lie that really didn't dictate that. So, let's watch. Hopefully this is the last shot of the day and we'll see something magical happen here. All right, so there's the flag. Monte knowing he needs a hole out for a chance to make the cut, and believe me, he's going to go for it. So back and through, looking at the stick pretty well, got the distance absolutely perfect, but just blocked it right very slightly, really slightly. So Monte has that putt to go 4 under for the day and 2 under for the tournament. So even if he makes that, it's looking like making the cut will not be possible. But if you guys have any words of encouragement or advice or anything else, or well wishes for Monte as he's making his comeback to try to play a lot more tournament golf before he turns 50. Leave him in the comments below. I know he reads them, and I know he would appreciate any positive feedback you guys have. So Monty will have that putt to shoot 69. And here's Blake after hitting two more. Blake again. We're saying this Blake for birdie quite a bit. So Blake Schmidt, this is to shoot 62. This is to shoot a 10 under 62. And this would be the lowest round of the tournament if he makes this putt. Small fist bump there. That's an amazing round of golf. That's definitely the lowest round of golf I've ever seen anybody play. Awesome. Monty's very good at those short putts. So 69 for Monty. One under for his 2016 Long Beach Open bid. So Monty will miss the cut, as the cut actually ended up being four under. Over 315 golfers cut to the low 60 and tie. So a very harsh cut. Here, let's check out the scorecard of Blake Schmidt here, as I asked Blake to see the stub that he was doing it. Yes, hold that. That is amazing. Look at that. So Blake went extremely low this day. Extremely low. That's great for him. All right, so let's check in on Monty and see his final thoughts
here. What are some of your final thoughts, Monty, on the tournament, now that it looks like it's over for you?
You know, it's over. I mean, one under's not going to make the cut. I did something these last 2 days. I realize the courses aren't that difficult, and you can spray it around and still get it done. But I did something these 2 days that I had an inability to do when I was a touring pro, is when I was just god-awful and had no game, somehow find a way to keep it respectable.
Yeah.
And that I did a really good job of that the last 2 days. I kept it respectable. And, you know, no one's going to say that 74-69 is good quality professional golf on these courses. But, you know, as bad as I was, I did a really good job of managing myself.
And a good start to your kind of season as it's beginning right now.
Right.
First tournament of your little mini season.
So I just need to get, I'm too steep. I need to get out of that. I couldn't hit anything over a 6-iron or a 7-iron.
Tempo-wise, you think you figured that part out.
But
steep still.
Still steep.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I cost myself probably 8 or 10 shots because anything 5-iron to 2-iron was 30 yards offline because I was coming in like that.
Okay, everybody, thanks for watching very much. Let me know in the comments below if you would like to see more tournament vlogs like these last two that we've had here on Be Better Golf. Thank you very much to DirectedForce.com. That is the putter that Monty was using. Thank you very much for sponsoring this video and helping make this happen. And thanks to everybody who has purchased the pitching prescription. These little things are maybe annoying to you guys to have these tiny advertisements, but it really makes these things possible because as some of you know, the work that goes into making these videos can be a little daunting, especially time-wise and the equipment that's needed. But thanks for watching. It's been a blast. Congratulations to Monty on a really good effort, and I'm really excited to see what he's got in store for his next tournament, as he has a bunch more coming up in the next few weeks. So thanks for watching, everybody. Bye.
Hey everybody, on Be Better Golf right now, you can see this video that Monty and I did. Monty gave me a lesson about pitching, because as you've seen in some of my vlogs, it's the weakest part of my game, but I really think soon it's gonna be a strength and something that I really enjoy doing.
Well, you weren't struggling much, because after you got the lesson, you beat me in a pitching contest.
And a game of horse.
Absolutely.
So, and it's something, it's a move that is really
universal.
It's universal. It's good for anybody to try it, so try it out. And I really think the information that we had in my lesson is gonna be valuable for everybody. So pitching prescription, check it out.